Dear fellow colleagues, let me introduce ourselves first. We are Jorge Castro, Amos Fernández, Iván Guerrero, and I'm Jesús González. All of us are students of University of León. This video will deal with identification and quantification of the area occupied by Banjar in Dio Bierzo since 1990 to 2011, applying remote sensing techniques. Due to the economical importance of the vine crop in the area of El Bierzo, and since it is the 20th anniversary of the start of the denomination of origin Bierzo, it is convenient to evaluate, quantify and determine the change of the crop to give us an idea of its evolution in the future. It is the mode we are here. During the season 2009 and 2010, in Spain was produced more than 34 million of hectoliters. Our study was focused in Dio Bierzo, where over 122,000 hectoliters of wine was produced per year. Remote sensing techniques were applied to identify and quantify the area occupied by vineyard crops in the study area. Due to the big extension of the study area, it was unthinkable to develop the goals with other techniques. Firstly, we talk about the study area. Dio Bierzo is placed at the northwest of Spain, and its vineyard crops occupies over 3,000 hectares. The main variety of vine cultivated is the variety of Mencia, who formed 65% of the total vine cultivated.
Our study main goals concerns identify vineyard crops at 90s and 2011. Identify vineyard crops at 90s and 2011. Quantify vineyard surface at 90s and 2011. Updating vineyard cover cartography to 2011. Detect changes in vineyard crops between 90s and 2011. ENVI was the software used to develop this study. This study was developed with 4 Landsat 4 and 5 images from TM sensor. Those images have a spatial resolution of 30 meters and a spectral resolution from 0.45 to 2.35 micrometers. Two of them are for the 90s and the other two are from the 2011. These pairs of images were selected to help the method to detect vineyard class due to the vine phonological change between images from spring and autumn. Corine Land Cover, it is a land cover map from Spain, developed by CNIG. We used those cartography to help us to find training areas and ground truth areas of vineyard class from the study area. Orthophotographies were given by PNOA. There were another tool to choose the training areas and the ground truth areas of the classes. They are not available from the 90s, so we use the oldest orthophotograph accessible. Orthophotograph from the 2004 has a spatial resolution of 25 cm and the one from 2011 has 50 cm. The classes developed in this study are broadleaf forest, perennial forest, agriculture, scrub, infrastructure, bare soil, water, vineyard, which are areas planted with vine which minimum surface is bigger than 30 per 30 meters, because it is the limit of the spatial resolution of the TM sensor. To get a fine classification of the images, it is important to select the proper feature space. A feature space is the amount of bands or vegetal indexes that are used. In this study, 4 feature spaces have been provided, getting better results with the feature space that excludes the band number 1, that encompasses from 0.45 to 0.52 micrometers. Then we obtain this separability measure, focusing on the relationship between vineyard class and the other classes. The values given by this measure were plenty satisfactory.
Before getting results, we need to prepare the images to start working properly. A calibration of reflectance top of the atmosphere was applied to all images. There were not applied other radiometric corrections such as atmospheric correction. The untasseled cap transformation was calculated to enhance the vegetation land covers. After that, a coating of the images were produced to make easier the processing of the images. To finish in the preprocessing part, each pair of the images were combined to form a unique image. So, at the end of this process, we only have one image per year. Because of the application of supervised classification algorithm, training areas were needed for each class. The amount of training areas per class is more than 100 pixels. Then the supervised classification algorithms selected were maximum likelihood and neural net. For maximum likelihood, algorithm probability threshold was applied a value of 90%. Otherwise, for the neural net, was applied with one hidden layer and 1000 iterations. Next step is the classification accuracy assessment. To execute the accuracy assessment, ground truth areas were selected from orthophotographs. The amount of pixels of ground truth areas were over 50. These assessments are based on comparing these ground truth areas with the same pixels of the classificated images, obtaining confusion matrix. The kappa statistic, overall productors and users accuracy were calculated from confusion matrix. These statistics and accuracies were used to refuse or choose the suitable classification for each year. Obtained the suitable classification of each year, the next step is the change detection. This method is based on comparing pixel per pixel to classificated images. Like classificated images, the accuracy assessment is needed to verify our change detection. To perform this, ground truth errors were selected as well. These ground truth errors selected were from areas where bindings changed to other coverage, where other coverage became bindings and areas where bindings did not change. Also, the kappa statistic, overall, productors and users' accuracy were calculated for this accuracy assessment.
The results of the classifications are described next. For the two images, maximum likelihood was selected due to a higher value of the kappa statistic and producer's accuracy than the neural network values. In the 90s, the maximum likelihood kappa statistic has a value of 0.78. The confidence threshold of the producer's accuracy was from 78.2 to 96.1%. The kappa statistic of the maximum likelihood classification images from 2011 reached the value of 0.79. The producer's accuracy confidence threshold from the 2011 classification was from 70.7 to 91.7%. Then, the result of the change detection value are as follows. The kappa statistic value obtained was 0.6. The overall accuracy was 73.34%. The producer's accuracy confidence threshold from the no change class was from 45.3 to 65.8%. The value of the producer's accuracy confidence threshold from the change of binder crops to other classes was from 80.4 to 91.4%. Finally, the producer's accuracy confidence threshold of the change from all the other classes to binder class was from 89.8 to 10%. In this table, it shows the changes between classes, so we can see the gains and losses of the classes' surfaces. As a remarkable result, a gain of binder surface was detected about 4,600 hectares.
In this slide, the resulting updated cartography from 2011 was shown. In this slide, the change detection image for Vineyard was displayed. Finally, as a conclusion, an outstanding factor to determine the accuracy of our results depends on the accuracy from the original data. The vineyard classification through remote sensing with medium spatial resolution sensor becomes complex due to the main part of the pixels developed into will be heterogeneous. It is noticed that in a vineyard, the main part of the surface belongs to arable soil, and a minor part owns to vine plant. In consequence of the arable soil's influence, complicates the correct vineyard's identification. In this case, we think it would be interesting to use another sensor imagery instead of Landsat to get better results for a suitable identification of vineyards. To conclude, we would like to thank you for your attention.